Pentagon is now making it official. President Trump is reducing troop levels in Afghanistan and Iraq 5 days before President-elect Biden takes office. Here's Martha Raddatz.
Just over a week after President Trump fired Defense Secretary Mark Esper, who warned the White House of the dangers of a rapid withdrawal from Afghanistan, Trump's new defense secretary made it official.
By January 15th, 2021, our forces, their size in Afghanistan will be 2,500 troops. Our force size in Iraq will also be 2,500 by that same date.
That will mean 2,000 fewer troops in Afghanistan, 500 fewer in Iraq, and a far more rapid drawdown than anyone planned.
So 4 years ago, President Trump ran on a promise to put a stop to America's endless wars. President Trump is keeping that promise to the American people.
But within hours of that announcement, rockets were launched near the U.S. Embassy in Iraq, reportedly killing a child. And on Capitol Hill, the criticism was swift from both sides of the aisle, with fears the troops left behind will be more vulnerable.
This is the wrong thing to do. We want our troops home, but let's not bring them home in body bags.
I think a precipitous drawdown in either Afghanistan or Iraq would be a mistake.
Cautious words from Republicans and Democrats late today. Martha, that's the situation with Iraq and Afghanistan. But you're also learning more about Iran tonight, learning more about the president being talked out of a possible strike on Iran on their nuclear facilities.
That's right, David. Sources telling us the president asked his national security team for options in Iran, but they convinced him that a military strike could lead to a bigger conflict at a time when he is trying to get out of them. David?
Martha Raddatz on this again tonight for us. Martha, thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.